Russia Did It is a radical pamphlet distributed during the Seattle General Strike of 1919. It depicts a worker pointing ominously at a capitalist standing in front of a pile of money labeled War Profits. A signature for the illustration reads M. Pass. The text of the pamphlet reads as follows. Russia did it. Shipyard workers, you left the shipyards to enforce your demands for higher wages. Without you, your employers are helpless. Without you, they cannot make 1 cent of profit. Their whole system of robbery has collapsed. The shipyards are idle. The toilers have withdrawn, even though the owners of the yards are still there. Are your masters building ships? No. Without your labor power, it would take all the shipyard employers of Seattle and Tacoma working 8 hours a day the next 1,000 years to turn out one ship. Of what use are they in the shipyards? It is you and you alone who build the ships. You create all the wealth of society today. You make possible the $75,000 sable coats for millionaires' wives. It is you alone who can build the ships. They can't build the ships. You can. Why don't you? There are the shipyards. More ships are urgently needed. You alone can build them. If the masters continue their dog-in-the-manger attitude, not able to build the ships themselves and not allowing the workers to, there is only one thing left for you to do. Take over the management of the shipyards yourselves. Make the shipyards your own. Make the jobs your own. Decide the working conditions yourselves. Decide your wages yourselves. In Russia, the masters refused to give their slaves a living wage, too. The Russian workers put aside the bosses and their tool, the Russian government, and took over industry in their own interests. There is only one way out, a nationwide general strike, with its object the overthrow of the present rotten system, which produces thousands of millionaires and millions of paupers each year. The Russians have shown you the way out. What are you going to do about it? You are doomed to wage slavery till you die, unless you wake up, realize that you and the boss have not one thing in common, that the employing class must be overthrown, and that you, the workers, must take over the control of your jobs, and through them, the control over your lives, instead of offering yourselves up to the masters as a sacrifice 6 days a week, so that they may coin profits out of your sweat and toil.